Good morning, painting students. It's been a long time since I've checked in and said hi, so I figured I would come in to create a video and help you guys out with your next project. Most of you have emailed me or sent through Canvas your final painting for the iconic painting. Thank you for sending those in. Next week, we will do a Zoom all together so we can go through and share our finished paintings. A lot of you got to see the starting of people's paintings, but you didn't get to see the finished product, so we'll do that. The next project that we're going to be doing is a still life watercolor. And that first week when all this craziness started happening, I got together materials for you guys in a package, and you should have gotten two of the watercolor papers. So that's like the heavier paper. You should have gotten two of those, and then you should have gotten a set of watercolors, brushes, and then of course you'll need water and then a pencil. Now you have been given an assignment, or I should say assignments over the last couple weeks, to go in and gather some still life objects from around your house. They should be fairly small. You need to have different heights of objects, different shapes, so don't choose all the same shapes. Maybe some are geometric, some are organic. So if you're looking at mine, the box would be more of a geometric shape. The elephant is an organic shape. Plant is organic, but the clear vase that it's in would be geometric. And this is kind of a combination of both, that little watering can. And then we've got organic geometric. So have various sizes and various heights. And then, of course, different shapes and also different textures. So how something looks and feels, you wouldn't want to put like all glass items, and you probably wouldn't want to put all like fluffy or really textured items. Change the texture of your objects. The number of items you should have is about 5 to 7 objects. I have exactly five. If you start having too many of your still life objects, then it becomes too chaotic. So for when you're doing your setup and getting your objects, various heights, various shapes, various textures, various sizes, and then set them all up and in a nice space where you'll be able to paint in that area. And if you look here at my workspace, you can kind of see how I have everything set up where I can visually see the still life and also be painting at the same time.